This conference will now be recorded.
Welcome to the election process for the 2021-2022 APHA-ASP National Executive Committee. To challenge the national officer candidates' ability to think on their feet, the current APHA-ASP National Executive Committee has developed three predetermined thought questions for each of the candidates to answer. You will now hear from Stephanie Nguyen, candidate for the office of Speaker of the House from Rossmann University of Health Sciences. Stephanie, your first question is, what is one unique aspect of APHA-ASP as an organization, and how would you promote the utilization of this aspect to non-member student pharmacists?
Thank you, Juan. I truly believe that APHA-ASP is a unique organization for student pharmacists to become involved with, because they are truly one organization that puts student pharmacists at the forefront of advocacy and legislation and policy. We truly do have a collective voice as student pharmacists here, and in order to leverage these kinds of resources and to know the platform that APHA-ASP provides, I would make sure to speak to non-members about the different kinds of opportunities that they have to advocate through patient care, to also advocate through resolutions in the policy process, and to just have some amazing conversations that are well informed with student leaders from across the nation about the future of our profession. And so, yes, APHA-ASP is an amazing place to get started, especially if you want to learn about the scope of things that we can do as students and as future professionals, and how we can work collaboratively with other professionals in different disciplines and staff within APHA to ensure that we are really making waves as students during our 3, 4, 5, however many years you are a student pharmacist, so that you really are making the best of your experience here.
Thank you. Your second question is, in your opinion, what do you think is the most pressing issue facing healthcare today, and what can we do as a profession to address it?
As evidenced by the state of our pandemic, we have really noticed how disparities in healthcare have really escalated as marginalized communities and communities of color and communities that we should be advocating for throughout our careers are not receiving the same amount of care, same quality of care as everybody else. And given different levels of accessibility, and especially now that we are limited in terms of in-person interactions, we are limited in the number of appointments that different patients can make and the amount of times that we see patients face to face, those kinds of disparities are rapidly dividing. That is, unless we work together in order to unite as a voice, as student pharmacists, to ensure that we are closing those gaps and that we're having those conversations and we are making solutions, creative solutions, innovative solutions, to ensure that these are always going to be issues that are at the top of our future professional goals. And so I would say that currently we need to make sure that we're closing gaps in costs of care, that we are providing equal accessibility to our patients, providing equitable care, and identifying where those gaps are so that we can really evolve our profession in ways that are really meaningful to us. Because as the needs of our patients change, we know that our profession needs to change as well. And in order to determine the direction of where our profession needs to change, that is a conversation that we, as the future of our profession, as student pharmacists, we are talking about it and we are learning about it. And we are having conversations based on evidence, based on the critical trials that we are establishing over the years. As evidence comes to face, that we need to change and we need to do more in order to change. And we need to have more conversations.
Thank you, Stephanie. Your final question is, how do you think the current pandemic will affect the scope or practice of pharmacy moving forward? And what opportunities would you advocate for to move pharmacy forward?
Now more than ever before, people, so payers, legislators, communities, healthcare professionals are seeing that pharmacists are well trained and well equipped to be addressing the different needs of the pandemic, including vaccination efforts and patient education, spreading information that is accurate and correct and reliable about COVID-19, about immunizations, about future things that we can do in order to prioritize comorbidities and really make sure that our patients are receiving the full scope of care and practice that they deserve. And so with this pandemic, now more than ever, we are in a position to transform and advance the future of our profession. And already across states, different bills and different conversations have been escalating to the tops of the legislative sessions that encourage a broader scope of practice for pharmacists, especially as we talk about things like provider status, right? So compensation for the different things that we offer in terms of cognitive service to our patients, things like vaccination efforts, even things like encouraging a larger scope of responsibility for our tests. We know that our profession is changing, and now more than ever, we have shown that we are ready and we are well-skilled, we are highly educated to be helping our patients when our nation needs it the most, which is now during this pandemic when healthcare is in a dire state of emergency. And so now we truly do need to unite as a student body, and we need to start talking about what we do and advocate for our patients in our communities. And talk to our legislators, talk to our professors, our pharmacists, our healthcare professionals, where we work, to ensure that we are really making the impact that we want to see.
Thank you, Candidate Nguyen. This concludes the interview portion of the election process.